몹시 아프네. 세상이란 놈이 지갑기 덕분에 눌러보는 먼지 쌓인 되갚기. 넘어진 채 청하는 엇박자의 춤. 겨울이 오면 내 진짜 더 뜨거운 숨.
끝이 보이지 않아 출구가 있긴 한가 발이 떼지지 않아.
자리가 나를 부르는 파도처럼 밀려오는 너의 모습이 메마른 나의 마음속에 살며시 다가오면
잃어버린 시간 속에 나의 꿈들이 하나 둘씩 기억 속에 되살아나고 새로운 부푼 희망 속에 가슴은 설레있네.
행복이란 멀게만 느껴지지만 우리 맘속에 있는 걸
언젠가는 너에게 말해줄 거야. 내일이 찾아오면 언젠가는 너에게 말해줄 거야. 내일이 찾아오면
아리아나 선생님.
저는 리오 선생님입니다. Before starting today's class, we will first check the correct answer to the homework given in the last class. This is the correct answer to homework. First, 노래를 듣는 것은 즐거워요. One more time. 노래를 듣는 것은 즐거워요. It means I enjoy listening to the songs. Second, 성경을 읽는 것은 조금 어려워요. 성경을 읽는 것은 조금 어려워요. It means reading the Bible is a little difficult. Third, 저는 산책하는 것을 좋아해요. 저는 산책하는 것을 좋아해요. In English, I like to take a walk. Fourth, 우리 학교 축구팀을 응원하는 것은 그들을 더 힘나게 해요. 우리 학교 축구팀을 응원하는 것은 그들을 더 힘나게 해요. It means cheering for our school soccer team makes them stronger. Fifth, 매일 우유를 마시는 것은 몸 안에 있는 뼈를 튼튼하게 만들어줘요. One more time. 매일 우유를 마시는 것은 몸 안에 있는 뼈를 튼튼하게 만들어줘요. In English, drinking milk every day makes the bones in your body strong. Wasn't it difficult to do your homework? Wow, that's great.
Well, before starting today's class, we will review what we learned last time. Do you remember the 는 것 we learned last time? Let's review about 는 것. 는 것 is used after the stem of a verb. It is an expression that makes verbs we use like noun in sentence. It can be used like a noun in front of 이다. So after 는 것, particles such as 는, 이가, 을, or 이다 can be used.
Yes, for example, there is a sentence, 저는 뛰는 것을 좋아합니다. Here, 뛰는 것 is a noun that is a variation of the basic verb 뛰다. Do you understand? Yes, but when do we use 는 것? Teacher Ariana?
Let me explain. 는 것 has the same form, which does not change depending on the final consonant or not. First, if you remove 다 from the basic form of verb, the stem will remain in the verb. After that, 는 것 is added. For example, if you look at the verb 읽다, is there a final consonant? After that, 는 것 is used. Then it becomes 읽는 것. Also, 는 것 is used even if there is no final consonant in the stem of the verb.
Yes, for example, if you look at the verb 보다, there is no final consonant, right? After that, 는 것 is used. Then it becomes 보는 것. Can you see the same form with or without final consonant in the stem of a verb?
Yeah, it's really like that. But there is one exception. If there is a final consonant, 리을, at the verb, remove the 리을 and attach the 는 것. For example, there is a sentence, 제 남동생은 밖에서 노는 것을 좋아합니다. Here, because the base verb 놀다 has a final consonant 리을. 리을 is removed and 는 것 are added.
After reviewing, I remember what we learned last time. Then, we will explain more easily through example sentences in which grammar is applied. This is an example sentence. 제 취미는 음악을 듣다 이에요. When we remove 다 from the verb 듣다, we can use 는 것. So it becomes 제 취미는 음악을 듣는 것 이에요.
Yes, do you remember after reviewing?
Yes, thank you. So, can you tell us the table of contents before starting today's class, Teacher Ariana?
Of course. I'll give you the contents for today's class. First, let's learn the grammar concepts of Korean. Second, let's do some problem solution to practice the grammar we learned. Third, after solving the problem, we will learn the concept by applying our knowledge. Fourth, we will practice by lifting the conversation directly through conversation class. Lastly, we will take the time to organize the class and announce the homework.
Yes, thank you. Then we will start the class. Today's lesson is the present tense 으니까 and 니까. 으니까 and 니까 is used after adjectives, verb stems. It is used to say the reason for the sentence that follows a connective ending.
You don't understand well, don't you? I'll explain with an example sentence. There is a sentence, 공원에서 매일 뛰니까 몸이 건강해졌어요. Here, the reason I feel healthy is because I run through the park every day. Like this, we can use this grammar when we want to tell a reason.
By the way, are you curious when we use the present tense 으니까 and 니까? Let's find out. First, if you remove 다 from the basic form of a verb, the stem will remain in the verb. After that, we add 으니까 and 니까. If the verb has a final consonant, 으니까 is used. For example, if you remove 다 from the verb 먹다, is there a final consonant 기역 in the word 먹? Then we use 으니까 after. So it becomes 먹으니까.
Conversely, if the verb does not have a final consonant, then 니까 is used. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 자다, the stem has no final consonant, so it becomes 자니까 by adding 니까.
Yes, but there are two exceptions. First, if the final consonant of the verb is 리을, 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 만들다, is there a final consonant 리을? Then 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. So it becomes 만드니까.
The second is that if there is a final consonant 비읍, 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 춥다, is there a final consonant 비읍? Then 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. So it becomes 추니까.
Yeah, right. Then, shall we learn more through example sentences? This is the first example sentence. 시간이 없다. 택시를 탑시다. When we remove 다 from the verb 없다, we can use 으니까 because there is a final consonant. So it becomes 시간이 없으니까 택시를 탑시다.
This is the second example sentence. 영화가 곧 시작하다. 휴대폰을 꺼주세요. When we remove 다 from the verb 시작하다, we can use 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 영화가 곧 시작하니까 휴대폰을 꺼주세요.
Yes, this is the third example sentence. 오늘은 덥다. 좀 쉬어요. In the verb 덥다, bib is removed and u is added. And 니까 is used at the end. So it becomes 오늘은 더우니까 좀 쉬어요.
Yes. Did you understand all the grammar? Then this time, we will have time to practice while solving problem that apply the grammar we learned today.
안녕하세요. I'm Scott.
And I'm Kelly, who will solve problems with you. Then we will try to solve the problem with the grammar we learned today. The first problem will be solved with us, and for the second problem, we will give a little time, so please try it. Yes, this is the first problem. 오늘은 바쁘다. 쇼핑하러 갈 수 없어요. How can we change 바쁘다? Yes, right. 오늘은 바쁘니까 쇼핑하러 갈 수 없어요. When we remove 다 from the verb 바쁘다 and 니까 is added because there is no final consonant, so it becomes 바쁘니까. Okay, one more time. 바쁘니까. Yes, let's read it together. 오늘은 바쁘니까 쇼핑하러 갈 수 없어요. Yes, one more time. 오늘은 바쁘니까 쇼핑하러 갈 수 없어요.
Next problem. 이 옷은 너무 작다. 좀 큰 옷 주세요. How can we change 작다? I will give 5 seconds. Yes, it is. 이 옷은 너무 작으니까 좀 큰 옷 주세요. When we remove 다 from the verb 작다, 으니까 is added. Because there is a final consonant, so it becomes 작으니까. Let's read it together. 이 옷은 너무 작으니까 큰 옷 주세요. Repeat after me aloud. 이 옷은 너무 작으니까 큰 옷 주세요.
Yes, next problem. 날씨가 춥다. 두꺼운 코트를 입으세요. How can you change 춥다? I will give you 5 seconds. That's right. 날씨가 추우니까 두꺼운 코트를 입으세요. When we remove 다 from the verb 춥다 and 비읍 is removed and 우니까 is added because there is a final consonant 비읍, so it becomes 추우니까. One more time. 추우니까. Yes, let's read it together. 날씨가 추우니까 두꺼운 코트를 입으세요. Okay, one more time. 날씨가 추우니까 두꺼운 코트를 입으세요. Yes, everyone did so well.
Next one. 제가 그 식당을 알다 같이 가요. How can we change 춥다? I will give you 5 seconds. Yes, you did it. 제가 그 식당을 아니까 같이 가요. When we remove 다 from the verb 알다, 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. Because there is a final consonant, 리을, so it becomes 아니까. One more time. 아니까. Okay, let's read it together. 제가 그 식당을 아니까 같이 가요. One more time. 제가 그 식당을 아니까 같이 가요.
Yes, next one. 친구가 준 과자를 먹다. 배가 불러요. How can we change 먹다? I'll give you 5 seconds. 예스. Yes. 친구가 준 과자를 먹으니까 배가 불러요. When we remove 다 from the verb 먹다 and 으니까 is added because there is a final consonant. So it becomes 먹으니까. One more time. 먹으니까. Yes. Then let's read it together. 친구가 준 과자를 먹으니까 배가 불러요. Okay, one more time. 친구가 준 과자를 먹으니까 배가 불러요.
Next problem. 쿠키를 굽다. 너무 덥다. How can we change 굽다? I will give you 5 seconds. Yes, you got it? Okay. 쿠키를 구우니까 너무 덥다. When we remove 다 from the verb 굽다, 비읍 is removed and 우니까 is added because there is a final consonant, 비읍. So, it becomes 구우니까. Let's read it together. 쿠키를 구우니까 너무 덥다. One more time. 쿠키를 구우니까 너무 덥다.
Yes, this time we will look at the verb and solve the problem of changing it accordingly. Yes, this is the first problem. 가다. 가다. How can we change 가다? Yes, that's right. 가니까. Okay, one more time. 가니까. When we remove 다 from the verb 가다 and 니까 is added because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 가니까. Okay, repeat after me. 가니까.
Yes, next problem. 읽다. One more time. 읽다. How can we change 읽다? Yes, the answer is 읽으니까. 한 번 더 할게요. 읽으니까. When we remove 다 from the verb 읽다, 으니까 is added because there is a final consonant. So it becomes 읽으니까.
Yes, next problem. 살다. One more time. 살다. How can we change 살다? Yes, the answer is 사니까. Okay, one more time. 사니까. When we remove 다 from the verb 살다, 리을 is removed and 니까 is added because there is a final consonant, 리을. So it becomes 사니까.
Next problem. 놀다. 놀다. How can we change 놀다? Yes, good. The answer is 노니까. 노니까. When we remove 다 from the verb 놀다, 리을 is removed and 니까 is added because there is a final consonant 리을, so it becomes 노니까.
Yes. Next problem. How can we 눕다? 눕다. Okay. How can we change 눕다? Yes, that's right. The answer is 누우니까. Okay, one more time. 누우니까. When we remove 다 from the verb 눕다, 비읍 is removed and 우니까 is added because there is a final consonant, 비읍. So it becomes 누우니까. One more time. 누우니까.
Yes, everyone did a good job. And you too?
Yeah.
This is time to finish the problem solving time. Next time, we will have a conversation time with Ethan and Grace.
Hello, I'm Ethan.
And I'm Grace.
Grace, who is your favorite celebrity?
I like BTS the most. Yesterday, my friend gave me 2 tickets, K-pop concert tickets. Would you like to go with me if you have time?
Yeah, sure. When we go to the concert, we can see not only BTS, but also other singers, right?
Of course. I'm so excited to see the celebrities. We've always seen only in videos with our own eyes and listen to the songs directly.
Okay, I'm very excited too. Then, shall we go to the concert today?
Wow! The concert hall is really big! Ethan, have you been to the concert many times?
Not really, no. I have never been to a concert. This is the first time. 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요.
이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요. The meaning of this sentence is coming here, I feel like I'm having a new experience. Can you see the grammar? 니까 we learned today? Here, 오다 is come. When 다 is removed from the verb 오다. We use it 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 오니까. Please repeat after me. 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요.
Okay, here 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요. Okay, here is 새로운. 새로운 is new, right? And 경험 is experience. Everyone, what do you say new in Korean? Yes, it is 새로운.
Then, what do you say experience in Korean? Yes, it is 경험.
Yes, you did really well. Then, please repeat after me slowly. Okay? 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요.
Repeat after me. 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요. Please repeat after me quickly. 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요.
Okay. 이곳에 오니까 새로운 경험을 하는 것 같아요. Who is the performing now?
Wow! BTS is performing now! Can we see the performance in front?
Okay. 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 갈까요? The meaning of this sentence is there are a lot of people in the front. So should we go back a little? Can you see the use of the grammar 으니까 we learned today? 많다 is many. When 다 is removed from the verb 많다, there is a final consonant. So we can use 으니까. So it becomes 많으니까. Please repeat after me. 그래요. 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요.
그래요. 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요. Let's quickly say it this time. 그래요. 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요.
그래요. 앞쪽 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요.
Here, up is front. 사람 is people. And 뒤 is back. Everyone, what do you say front in Korean? Yes, right. Up.
Then what do you say people in Korean? Yes, you're right. 사람.
What do you say back in the Korean? Yes, right. 뒤.
Please repeat after me slowly. 그래요. 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요.
그래요. 그런데 앞쪽은 사람이 많으니까 조금 뒤로 가요. Today's performance was really cool. I will never forget.
Yes, it was. I really enjoyed it too. 콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
The meaning of this sentence is now that the concert is finished, it's already night. Can you see the grammar we learned today? 니까 used here. 끝나다 is finished.
When 다 is removed from the verb 끝나다, we can use 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 끝나니까. Please repeat after me. 콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요. Here, 벌써 is already. 밤 is night. What do you say already in Korean? Yes, it is 벌써.
Then what do you say night in Korean? Yes, it is 밤. You guys remember really well.
Then repeat after me slowly. 콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
Let's quickly say it this time. 콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
콘서트가 끝나니까 벌써 밤이 되었네요.
이든, would you like to go to baseball field next time?
That sounds good. Grace, but aren't you hungry?
I'm a little hungry. 배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요?
Okay, 배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요? The meaning of this sentence is because you are hungry. Would you like to eat a snack? If you look at this sentence, 니까 was used. 배고프니까 is hungry. When 다 is removed from the 배고프다, we add 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 배고프니까. Okay? Please repeat after me. 배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요?
배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요? Here, 배고프다 is hungry. 간식 is snack. 먹다 is eat. Everyone, what does hungry say in Korean? Yes, it is 배고프다.
Then what does snack say in Korean? Yes, it is 간식.
What do you say eat in Korean? Yes, it is 먹다.
Repeat after me loudly. 배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요?
배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요? Let's quickly say it this time. 배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요?
배고프니까 간식 먹고 갈래요? Yes, you are really, really good.
Thank you. I got much better with snacks.
Are you tired a lot after going to the concert today? Grace, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
Grace, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요. The meaning of this sentence is Grace, tomorrow is the weekend, so take a break. If you look at the sentence here, can you see that the grammar 니까 we learned today? I explained that 이니까 and 니까 are added after the noun because the noun 주말 has a final consonant. We add 이니까, so it becomes 주말이니까.
Okay, please repeat after me. Grace, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
Grace, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
Okay, here is 내일. 내일 is tomorrow. And 주말 is weekend. 편하게 is comfortable. Everyone, what do you say tomorrow in Korean? Yes, it is 내일.
Everyone, what do you say weekend in Korean? Yes, it is 주말.
And what do you say comfortable in Korean? Yes, it is 편하게.
Then repeat after me slowly. 그레이스, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
그레이스, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
Let's quickly say it this time. 그레이스, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요.
그레이스, 내일은 주말이니까 편하게 쉬어요. You did so well. Shall we clap once for all of you who studied hard today? Okay. And this time, this is the end of the conversation time. So then we will invite Ariana and Rio and have some time to wrap it up.
Everyone, did you understand all the grammar we learned today? If you understand, make a circle over your head. Yes, thank you. Let's leave it about present tense 으니까 and 니까. 으니까 and 니까 is used after adjective verb stems. It is used to say the reason for the sentence that follows as a connective ending.
I will explain with an example sentence. There is a sentence, 공원에서 매일 뛰니까 몸이 건강해졌어요. Here, the reason I feel healthy is because I run through the park every day. Like this, we can use this grammar when we want to tell a reason.
By the way, when we use the present tense 으니까 and 니까, let me explain. First, if you remove 다 from the basic form of a verb, the stem will remain in the verb. After that, we add 으니까 and 니까. If the verb has a final consonant, 으니까 is used. For example, if you remove 다 from the verb 먹다, is there a final consonant 기역 in the word 먹? Then we use 으니까 after, so it becomes 먹으니까.
Conversely, if the verb does not have a final consonant, then 니까 is used. For example, if you remove 다 from the verb 자다, isn't there a final consonant? So it becomes 자니까.
Yes, but there are two exceptions. First, in the final consonant of the verb is 리을. 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 만들다, is there a final consonant 리을? Then 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. So it becomes 만드니까.
The second is that if there is a final consonant 비읍, 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 춥다, is there a final consonant 비읍? Then 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. So it becomes 추우니까.
Yeah, right. Then shall we leave more through example sentence? This is the first example sentence. 시간이 없다. 택시를 탑시다. When we remove 다 from the verb 없다, we can use 으니까 because there is a final consonant. So it becomes 시간이 없으니까 택시를 탑시다.
This is the second example sentence. 영화가 곧 시작하다. 핸드폰을 꺼주세요. When we remove 다 from the verb 시작하다, we can use 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 영화가 곧 시작하니까 핸드폰을 꺼주세요.
This is the third example sentence. 오늘은 덥다. 좀 쉬어요. In the verb 덥다, 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. And 니까 is used at the end. So it becomes 오늘은 더우니까 좀 쉬어요.
Yes, did you remember all the grammar? If you understand, make a circle over your head. Yes, thank you. Teacher Ariana, what should we do before the class is over?
Yes, it's time to do homework. Today's homework is completing sentence using the 으니까 and 니까 grammar we'll learn today. Yes, I hope you will do hard on your homework again this time.
Yes, lastly, will we have time to learn basic verb, not buzzword?
Hello everyone! We have time to learn buzzwords from lecture 1 to lecture 10. From lecture 11, we will learn basic Korean verb. The verb we will learn today are 먹다, 좋다, and 걷다. First, 먹다 is a verb. The meaning is eat. When you eat food, you can use the verb 먹다. For example, if you are eating pizza, you can say 피자를 먹다. Second, 좋다 is a verb. The meaning is like. You can use this verb for people or things you like. For example, you can say 나는 전국이 좋다. Third, 걷다 is a verb. The meaning is walk. You can use it when you walk in any place. For example, you can say 나는 공원에서 걷다. Do you guys understand? Use the verb we learned today in your daily life. Yes, then we will end today's class here. 여러분, 다음 시간에 봐요. Bye!
Hi everyone, good to see you again. I'm Glenn, Mind Lecturer for all of you, and this is our fourth video that we've been doing together. Hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. I know I am. It's a lot of fun putting these together. I'm sorry sometimes it takes a while for me to post the new video. It's just that with planning, shooting, and editing, because I do it all myself, it takes a little bit of time. But hopefully the end result is worth it and you guys are enjoying it. So today we're going to continue from last week's lesson. Last week we talked about harmful thoughts. We talked about how we look at the symptoms that we have in our life. We trace them back to the source and we find out what thought kind of kicked off those symptoms. And after that, we look for a solution and how to prevent ourselves from falling into that same thought again. Well, today we're going to kind of continue on this process. We're going to talk a little bit about what happens when you actually start tracing back your actions and your feelings to the thought they originated from. And when we do that, we'll find that the thoughts we thought were good, the thoughts we believed to be beneficial for us, weren't always what they seemed. This is today's topic, and to start off, we're going to have our first five, where I'm going to show you guys a quick video, and I think you'll get a kick out of it. Take a look.
Do you feel the helplessness? My keys.
I'll go.
Do you feel the gratitude? And what do you feel now?
So let me ask you guys, was that what you expected was going to happen in the beginning? I'll tell you what, a friend of mine showed me this video a couple weeks ago and totally caught me off guard, right? You see this little old lady, she's all kind, you know, she needs help getting inside. Next thing you know, she's robbing this entire apartment and cleaning it out. I'll tell you what, I don't think anyone would ever suspect her of being a burglar, but that's why she's probably so successful, right? So if you haven't really caught on, the theme today has a lot to do with expectations, or what we think, versus reality and what actually happens. Let's take a look at some pretty funny expectation versus reality memes that you can find online, and let's just kind of react to these together, okay? All right, so the first one, I think this is a classic. If anyone has ever been to McDonald's or Burger King, the burgers never look like how they look in the pictures, right? This is something that I think we can all identify with. I mean, gosh, that is just sad. But, you know, they have to make it look appetizing for a reason, right? All right, let's go to the next one. Okay, now this is from Subway. Do you guys like Subway? I used to eat Subway when I was in college all the time. But, you know, I don't think I ever had a sandwich that looked as bad as the one on the right. Whoever took this picture, I think they probably were really mean to the employee or something, because that is a very bad looking sandwich. All right, let's look at the next one. Okay, this is just horrifying. When I was little, I remember that they used to make these kinds of ice creams, like especially they had the Looney Tunes like Bugs Bunny or Tweety Bird, and it didn't look like it looked like on the box, but this SpongeBob is just horrifying. Like, what's happened to his eyes? Like, that's terrible. That looks nothing like the box. Okay, I don't even know what they were going for here. This does not look like that panda even one bit. It's not even the same color. Yeah, I can't justify this one. Here, I mean, you gotta give them, give them at least points for effort. I mean, they got it pretty close. At least the shape is the same thing. But besides that, I think all the details are lost, right? All right, A for effort though. All right, so that's some about food. Let's look at some other ones. Okay, now this one definitely rings true. Whether you're working from home or going to school from home, I think this is something we can all relate with, right? You wanna be super productive. You wanna set up your desk and make a cup of coffee or some tea. You wanna get your notebook out and your pen and your paper, and you wanna be ready to have a productive day. But what ends up actually happening? Well, for me, I end up feeling too tired to really get started with work, and I just wanna go back to sleep. How about you guys? when you have to go to classes through Zoom or through Google Hangouts, like, are you able to actually get through the day productively, or do you just end up kind of playing games or going on TikTok or whatever? All right, let's take a look at another one. New Year's resolutions. I asked you guys last time if you made any resolutions, and I didn't make anything in particular, but I really do like to exercise. But the thing is, you know, when you're just reaching the end of the day and you're tired, it's so much easier just to kick back, to watch Netflix, to go to sleep, than it is to actually get off your butt and have to break a sweat and exercise, right? Especially for me, now that I have my baby daughter, it's a lot more work and it's a lot less time. So by the time you're done feeding her, burping her, and putting her to sleep, the whole day's already gone. All right, have you guys ever done online shopping before? I've never had an experience this bad. That literally just looks like a bed sheet. Okay. And this guy, first of all, I don't know what he was thinking even getting that shirt on the website. It doesn't even look like a nice shirt to begin with. But whatever he ended up with, the buttons are on the wrong side. It doesn't, the pocket's on the wrong side. That looks terrible. That's awful. Like, that's something you can make in your like elementary school class. All right. Just a few expectation versus reality memes. But let me ask you guys, what is your biggest expectation versus reality disappointment that you've had in life? Why don't you guys share with the class, with your teacher, with your friends, or if you're watching this on YouTube, leave a comment down below and tell me what's a big real-time expectation versus reality disappointment you've had. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. And this is gonna kind of segue into our main topic for today, which, as I said earlier, is how when we really look back on a lot of the thoughts that we have, we find that what seemed like a really great thought, or a thought that we were sure was true, turns out it was not so great. It turns out it was not true. It turns out it was completely different than what we expected. Hence, expectation versus reality. Now, this is something to really think about, because if this happens to us a couple times, then it's gonna kind of change the way we think about how we live our lives and how we follow every impulse or every thought that we get that pops up. So I'm gonna tell you guys a story that I heard recently, and I want you to think about this and think about what it means, and let's talk about it. So one day, a small boat went out on a voyage into the ocean. When they set off, they packed all the food and all the water and all the supplies that they needed. There were three guys in this small boat. But as they were going along in their voyage, they ended up running out of supplies. They ate all their food, they drank all their water, and worse yet, they got lost. They didn't know where they were. If they knew where they were, they could quickly go back the way they came, or they could quickly find land and get more supplies. But the thing is, they didn't know where they were. So day by day, as the sun beat down, they started to get sunburned, they started to become hungry, but worst of all, they had no drinking water, so they were super thirsty and super dehydrated. Have you guys ever been really dehydrated before? Like, if you don't drink any water or anything for one day, see what happens. You start to get a headache. You start to feel lightheaded. And if you try to do any physical activity, you feel really weak and you have no energy. Well, that's how these guys were. They were dying of thirst. And as they were on that boat, they were thinking, oh God, if we keep going like this, we're gonna die by tomorrow. All I want is just one glass of water, even one drop of fresh water. They can't drink the salt water in the ocean, because if they do, what's gonna happen? Well, first of all, it's not gonna taste good. But second of all, it'll actually speed up the process of them dehydrating and dying even quicker, because that water is filled with salt. So the thing is, day by day, they waited and hoped and prayed that somehow they could either be rescued or they would run into land. But one day, while they were looking along the horizon of the ocean, they spotted a little speck from far away, and they said, hey, you guys, look over there. What is that? And that little speck got closer and closer and closer, and they realized that it was another boat. We're saved. It's another boat. And they began to shout out, hey, over here. Help. We need help. They waved their arms and they took their shirt and waved it and spun it in the air. Anything they could do to get the attention of this boat. Well, sure enough, that boat from far away must have noticed them, because that boat got closer and closer and closer. And you know what they realized? This wasn't just a small boat. This was a huge ship that must have had a lot of crew members and probably a lot of food and a lot of water. So these three guys thought, we're saved. Yes, this is it. Thank God. So as the boat drew closer, eventually it pulled right up next to the small boat. And then the captain and some of the crewmates came over to the railing of their boat, and they were leaning over the railing looking down at these three men in their small boat. And they said, hey, what's wrong? What do you need? And the three men on the boat said, please, we've had no food and no water for days. We're lost in the ocean and we're dying. Can you give us some water? But contrary to what they expected would happen, the captain and his crewmen, they just started to laugh. They said, what are you talking about? If you're so thirsty, just take your bucket, draw it in the water around you and drink that. You're surrounded by water, all right? Bye. And then the captain and his crewmen got back in their boat and they kept on going along. So these three men in their boat, they were shocked and they were speechless. What the heck is going on? We thought that they were gonna lower down some water so we could drink it and we could survive. Or at least they should tell us, like, hey, you know, you're stuck in the middle of the ocean, so we'll give you a compass, or just follow us and you can quickly find land. But they didn't do any such thing and they just left. So again, these three guys, their hearts became full of despair, full of hopelessness, and they didn't know what to do. But finally, it got to the point where one of the three was so thirsty, he couldn't bear it anymore. So he took the bucket and he drew it into the water and he was about to drink. The other two guys tried to stop him. Hey, Jim, what are you doing? If you drink that water, you're gonna die of dehydration. But Jim said, I don't care. I'll just die. I'm too thirsty. And he chugged the water of the bucket. But after taking a drink and putting the bucket down, do you know what he said? You guys, this isn't salt water. This is fresh water. We're saved. We're saved. We can drink this water. And he started to drink more. The other guys couldn't believe it, but they took their hands, they scooped the water off the side of the boat, and they drank. And they thought it should surely be salty, but it was fresh. Do you know what happened? Without them knowing it, their boat had wandered into the Amazon River. Now, the Amazon River is obviously fresh water, but what you might not know is that in some parts of the river, it's so wide that you can't even see from side to side the land on either side of the river. So you think you're in the ocean, and actually you're in fresh water. Needless to say, these guys had plenty of water to drink, and they realized that they had come into the river, so it was easy for them to navigate and find their way safely so that they could survive and live happy lives after that. You guys, let's think about this story. These three guys had a thought. What was that thought? We are stuck in the middle of the ocean, and we cannot drink this salt water because if we do, we'll die even quicker. Now that makes a lot of sense, right? I mean, if you think about where they are and what they can see, they don't see any land around them. And they started their voyage off in the ocean. So it makes sense that that's what they would think. And also it makes sense that they would assume that this water is salt water. So if we even try drinking it, it's only gonna kill us faster, so we shouldn't touch it. This thought seems correct. It seems right and it seems true. But was it? No, it wasn't true at all. This thought was actually killing them. But as long as they believe this to be true, they're never going to realize that they're actually surrounded by fresh water and they're actually in the river. The longer they hold on to that thought, the longer they do not question that thought, the likelier it is that their lives are going to end and be very, very miserable. But when they realized that that thought wasn't true, what happened? They were able to throw that away. Oh, this isn't the ocean. This isn't salt water. They could drink the fresh water and they could survive. Everyone, the point I want to make here is thoughts, a lot of times they can deceive us. They can look really, really good, but it turns out they're actually really, really bad. At the same time, they can look really, really true when it turns out they weren't true at all. It's an expectation that's completely different from reality. I want you guys to think about your own lives. Did you ever have a thought that you thought was going to be so good if you followed it? It was going to be so good if you believed it. So you dwelled on that thought. You indulged in it. You followed it wherever it took you, this way, that way. But at the end, were you happy like you thought you would be? Were you satisfied? Were you fulfilled? Was your life better? Sometimes, maybe it did turn out that that thought was right. But many times, as you guys reflect on your lives and your hearts, what are we going to realize? It wasn't always the case. Thoughts, they can deceive us. They can be completely different from what we thought. And many times it turns out that they weren't true. I want you guys to do some reflection and think about a time in your life where that might have been the case. While you're reflecting on this, I want to show you guys another example that hopefully illustrates the point even further. Have you guys seen the movie called Inception? It's a very famous movie starring Leonardo DiCaprio. It was directed by Christopher Nolan. He's the same director who made the movies Interstellar and also the Dark Knight trilogy about Batman. Hopefully you guys have seen some of these movies. They're really great. I recommend you do if you haven't. Now, in Inception, the concept is very, very like out of this world. If you haven't seen it, let me do my best just to explain the groundwork. Basically, in this world that the director has created, the main character, Leonardo DiCaprio, his name is Cobb, he makes a living off of infiltrating the dreams of people. So he'll make someone go to sleep, they'll connect a machine to that person and to him, and then while that person is dreaming, he'll go inside their dream and he'll plant an idea. Now, when this person wakes up, they'll think that this idea is their own, because they didn't know that someone jumped into their dream and planted it there. And based off of that idea, they'll do something that Cobb or whoever paid Cobb wants them to do. For example, let's make just a hypothetical example. Let's say I work for McDonald's and I want to get you to crave a Big Mac, but you don't crave a Big Mac right now, but I want you to. I would meet Cobb and I would tell him, hey, I'll give you $100 if you can make Brenda go to sleep and then infiltrate Brenda's dream and plant the thought that she craves a Big Mac inside of her head. So Cobb will make you sleep, he'll go inside, plant the idea, and when you wake up, I really want a Big Mac. That's basically how it works. That's the simplified version, and that's what they call Inception in this movie. In the clip of the movie I'm gonna show you, spoiler alert, okay? This is something that happens near the end of the movie. As Cobb is infiltrating other people's dreams to plant these ideas in their heads, he keeps being met by his wife, and her name is Maud. But the thing is, it's revealed earlier on in the movie that Maud had already died by committing suicide already a long time ago. But she keeps appearing in his dreams, and for some reason Cobb is very guilty about it, and he feels very condemned and very sad, but we don't know why. Finally, in this clip, it's revealed what happened. So let's take a look.
What do you feel?
Guilt. I feel guilt, Maul. And no matter what I do, no matter how hopeless I am, no matter how confused, that guilt is always there, reminding me of the truth.
What truth?
The idea that caused you to question your reality came from me.
You planted the idea in my mind. What is she talking about?
The reason I knew Inception was possible was because I did it to her first. I did it to my own wife.
Why?
We were lost in here. I knew we needed to escape, but she wouldn't accept it. She had locked something away, something deep inside. A truth that she had once known, but chose to forget. And she couldn't break free. So I decided to search for it. I went deep into the recess of her mind and found that secret place. And I broke in. And I planted an idea. A simple little idea that would change everything. That her world wasn't real. waiting for a train. A train that'll take you far away. You know where you hope this train will take you. But you can't know for sure. Yet it doesn't matter. Now tell me why!
Because you're gonna get it!
That idea would grow in her mind like a cancer that even after she woke. That even after you came back to reality. That you continue to believe your world wasn't real. That death was the only escape.
Oh, no! Jesus!
You're infecting my mind.
I was trying to save you.
You betrayed me. But you can make amends. You can still keep your promise. We can still be together. Right here. In the world we built together.
Again, if you haven't seen the movie, I'm sorry. There are some spoilers here. But let's reflect on what this means. Now, when you see Maude, the biggest problem that she had was she always felt like she was still living in a dream and that she needed to wake up. Meaning she didn't feel that anything she saw was reality. She thought that she was still asleep, and only when she would wake up would she be able to meet reality. But the thing is, even when she actually did come back to the real world with her husband, she still thought she was in a dream. And that is why she ended up killing herself, because she thought that was the only way to truly wake up. It's revealed that this thought had a source. Do you guys remember we talked about tracing the symptoms back to the source? Well, this movie shows us really clearly where that thought came from. It was Cobb who actually visited her mind when she was asleep and planted the thought that everything around you is a dream, none of it is real. But he didn't know that this thought would carry on again and again in her life. And that is why she killed herself. If we think about it from Maude's perspective, she thought that everything was a dream and she was so sure of it. But actually, was that thought true? No, it turns out that it wasn't true. But because she couldn't realize that, because she couldn't be freed from that thought, that is why she ended up killing herself. And she left her children, and she left her husband, and she left the world. All because she was trapped by this thought. You guys, certain thoughts may seem like they're going to benefit us, that they're going to take us down a really great path. But the more and more we reflect and more we look back and see what kind of thoughts we've had and what they've made us do or how they've made us feel, what we begin to learn is not every thought is as good as it seems. Not every thought is as true as it seems. And I hope that as we continue this lesson, this will be something that you can continue to think about. Is this thought really true? Or is this a thought that is deceiving me? And when you start to have your guard up about all the thoughts that come in and come out, it'll help us a lot when it comes to governing our hearts and kind of managing our thought process. That way, we won't always just react with every little thought or impulse that pops up, but we'll have a chance to examine it a little more carefully. Now, I'm gonna wrap up the lesson today, but I wanna leave you guys with two questions to discuss, okay? With your friends, with your class, or in the comments. Number one, what was a thought that appeared good to you, but was actually harmful? And another way to phrase this is, what was a thought that appeared to be true to you, but was actually false? So I want you guys to kind of reflect on this a little bit, and let's talk more about thoughts, and let's talk more about this thinking process and how thoughts affect our hearts in the next lesson, all right? Until then, everyone stay warm, stay healthy. I'll see you guys in the next lecture. Bye.
Before starting today's class, we will first check the correct answer to the homework given in the last class. This is the correct answer to homework. First, 날씨가 좋으니까 나가요. One more time, 날씨가 좋으니까 나가요. This means go out because the weather is nice. Second is 길이 막히니까 지하철을 타고 가세요. One more time. 길이 막히니까 지하철을 타고 가세요. It means the road is blocked, so take the subway. Third is 지금 수업하고 있으니까 들어가지 마세요. One more time. 지금 수업하고 있으니까 들어가지 마세요. It means someone is in class right now, so you shouldn't go in. Wasn't it difficult to do your homework? Wow, that's great.
Well, before starting today's class, we will review what we learned this time. Well, before starting today's class, we will review what we learned last time. Do you remember the 으니까 and 니까 we learned last time? Let's review about present tense 으니까 and 니까. 으니까 and 니까 is used after adjective verb stems. It is used to say the reason for the sentence that follow as a connecting ending.
I will explain with an example sentence. There is a sentence, 공원을 매일 뛰니까 몸이 건강해졌어요. Here, the reason I feel healthy is because I run through the park every day. Like this, we can use this grammar when we want to tell a reason.
By the way, are you curious when we use the present tense 으니까 and 니까? Let's find out. First, if you remove 다 from the basic form of a verb, the stem will remain in the verb. After that, we add 으니까 and 니까. If the verb has a final consonant, 으니까 is used. For example, if you remove 다 from the verb 먹다, is there a final consonant 기역 in the word 먹? Then we use 으니까 after, so it becomes 먹으니까.
Conversely, if the verb does not have a final consonant, then 니까 is used. For example, if you remove 다 from the verb 자다, the stem has no final consonant, so it becomes 자니까 by adding 니까.
Yes, but there are two exceptions. First, if the final consonant of the verb is 리을, 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 만들다, is there a final consonant 리을? Then 리을 is removed and 니까 is added. So it becomes 만드니까.
The second is that if there is a final consonant 비읍, 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. For example, if 다 is removed from the verb 춥다, is there a final consonant 비읍? Then 비읍 is removed and 우 is added. So it becomes 추우니까.
Yeah, right. Then shall we remove more through example sentence? Yes, this is the first example sentence. 시간이 없다. 택시를 탑시다. When we remove 다 from the verb 없다, we can use 으니까 because there is a final consonant. So it becomes 시간이 없으니까 택시를 탑시다.
Okay, this is the second example sentence. 영화가 곧 시작하다. 휴대폰을 꺼주세요. When we remove 다 from the verb 시작하다, we can use 니까 because there is no final consonant. So it becomes 영화가 곧 시작하니까 휴대폰을 꺼주세요.
This is the third example sentence. 오늘은 덥다. 좀 쉬어요. In the verb 덥다, be읍 is removed and 우 is added. And 니까 is used and at the end. So it becomes 오늘은 더우니까 좀 쉬어요.
Yes. Do you remember after reviewing?
Yes, thank you. So can you tell us the table of contents before starting today's class, Teacher Liu?
Of course. I will give the contents for today's class. First, let's learn the grammar concepts of Korean. Second, let's do some problem solutions to practice the grammar we learned. Third, after solving the problem, we will learn the concept by applying our knowledge. First, we will practice by repeating the conversation directly through conversation class. Lastly, we will take the time to organize the class and announce the homework.
Yes, thank you. Then we will start the class. Today's lesson is the past tense 왔으니까, 었으니까, and 했으니까. The grammar we will learn today is used in the same meaning as the last lecture. But last time, we learned the present tense, and today we will learn the past tense. First, let's learn what form it is used for. Let's look at when 왔으니까 is used. 왔으니까 is used when an adjective or a vowel of a verb and with 아 or 우.
For example, when looking at the verb 가다, 다 is first arrested. Then the verb of the verb is 아, right? In the case, 왔으니까 is used after that. So, we can say 갔으니까.
Next, when looking at the adjective 작다, 다 is erased first. Then the vowel of the adjective is 아, right? In that case, 왔으니까 is used after that. So, we can say 작았으니까.
Ah, okay. Then I will explain when 었으니까 is used. When the vowel of an adjective or verb is not 아 or 오, but the rest of the vowel 었으니까 is used. For example, if you look at the verb 만들다, 다 is erased first. Then you can see that the vowel vowels of the verb and with the verb 으 rather than 아 or 오. In the case 었으니까 is used after that. So we can say 만들었으니까.
Next, if you see the adjective 길다, 다 is erased first, then you can see that the vowel of the verb and with 이. In the case 었으니까 is used after that. So we can say 길었으니까.
Yes. Lastly, I will explain when 했으니까 is used. Verbs or adjectives ending in 하다 can be used by changing them to 했으니까. For example, in the verb 공부하다, the last is 하다. In the case, 했으니까 is used after that. So, we can say 공부했으니까.
Next, in the adjective 건강하다, It ends with 하다 as well. In that case, 했으니까 is used after that. So we can say 건강했으니까.
Ah, I understood exactly which verb or adjective this grammar is used after. Then, from now on, let's practice more while looking at the example sentences. This is the first example sentence. 공부를 열심히 하다. 좋은 결과가 있을 거예요. If you apply the grammar we learned today, it becomes a sentence that says 공부를 열심히 했으니까 좋은 결과가 있을 거예요. Here, 했으니까 is used because the verb ends in 하다.
This is the second example sentence. 이 영화는 시청하다. 다른 영화를 봐요. Here, 했으니까 is used because the verb ends in 시청하다. Then it becomes 이 영화는 시청했으니까 다른 영화를 봐요.
Okay, this is the third example sentence. 어제 피자를 먹다. 오늘은 스파게티 먹을래요? In this sentence, if you remove the 다 from the verb 먹다, you can see that it ends with a different vowel than the vowel 아 or 오. So we can use 었으니까. Then it becomes 어제 피자를 먹었으니까 오늘은 스파게티 먹을래요?
This is the last example. 어제 입었던 치마가 작다. 오늘은 큰 치마를 입어요. In this sentence, if you remove 다 from the verb 작다, you can see that it ends with the vowel 아. So we can use 왔으니까. Then it becomes 어제 입었던 치마가 작았으니까 오늘은 큰 치마를 입어요.
Do you understand? If you understand, please make a circle over your head. Yes, thank you. Then we will take time to practice with Scott and Kelly to apply the grammar we just learned.
Hello,
I'm Scott.
And I'm Kelly, who will solve problems with you. Then, we will try to solve the problem with the grammar we learned today. The first problem will be solved with us, and for the second problem, we will give you a little time, so please try it. This is the first problem. 어젯밤에 많이 못 자다. 지금 졸려요. What should we change 자다 to? Yes, that's right. 어젯밤에 많이 못 잤으니까 지금 졸려요. Because the verb is 아 in the verb 자다. So, 왔으니까 is added to make 잤으니까. Let's say it together. 어젯밤에 많이 못 잤으니까 지금 졸려요. Okay, one more time. 어젯밤에 많이 못 잤으니까 지금 졸려요.
Yes, next problem. 시험이 끝나다. 저녁 식사 같이 할까요? What should we change 끝나다 to? I'll give you 5 seconds. Yeah, that's right. The answer is 시험이 끝났으니까 저녁 식사 같이 할까요? Because the verb is 아 in the verb 끝나다. 왔으니까 is added to make 끝났으니까. Let's read it together. 시험이 끝났으니까 저녁 식사 같이 할까요? One more time. 시험이 끝났으니까 저녁 식사 같이 할까요?
Yes, thank you. Next problem. 6시에 만나기로 하다. 지금 나가야 해요. What should we change 하다 to? I'll give you 5 seconds. Yes, that's right. 6시에 만나기로 했으니까 지금 나가야 해요. In this sentence, 했으니까 is used because the verb 하다 ends with 다. Let's say it again. 6시에 만나기로 했으니까 지금 나가야 해요. Okay, repeat after me. 6시에 만나기로 했으니까 지금 나가야 해요.
Okay, next problem. 컴퓨터가 조금 전에 고장나다. 다른 컴퓨터를 쓰세요. What should we change 고장나다 to? I'll give you 5 seconds. Yeah, that's right. Because the verb is 아 in the verb 고장나다. 아스니까 is added to make 고장났으니까. Let's read it together. 컴퓨터가 조금 전에 고장났으니까 다른 컴퓨터를 쓰세요. One more time. 컴퓨터가 조금 전에 고장났으니까 다른 컴퓨터를 쓰세요.
Yes, next problem. 오늘 일을 많이 하다. 이제 집에 가서 푹 쉬세요. What should we change 하다 to? Okay, I give you 5 seconds. Yes, great. The answer is 오늘 일을 많이 했으니까 이제 집에 가서 푹 쉬세요. Yes, in the second sentence, 했으니까 is used because the verb 하다 ends with 하다. Let's say it together. 오늘 일을 많이 했으니까 이제 집에 가서 푹 쉬세요. Okay, one more time. 오늘 일을 많이 했으니까 이제 집에 가서 푹 쉬세요.
Yes, thank you. This is the last problem. 어제 점심에 피자 먹다. 오늘은 파스타 먹어요. What should we change 먹다 to? I will give you 5 seconds. Yes, that's right. The answer is 어제 점심에 피자를 먹었으니까 오늘은 파스타를 먹어요. Because the verb is 어 in the verb 먹다. And 었으니까 is added to make 먹었으니까. Repeat after me. 어제 점심에 피자를 먹었으니까 오늘은 파스타를 먹어요. One more time. 어제 점심에 피자를 먹었으니까 오늘은 파스타를 먹어요.
Okay, yes. Next, let's look at the verbs or adjective and change them to the grammar we learned today. Okay, this is first problem. 가다. 가다. Yes. What should we change 가다 to? Yes, that's right. The answer is 갔으니까. One more time. 갔으니까. It's because the verb is 아 in the verb 가다. So, 왔으니까 is added to make 갔으니까.
Next problem. 읽다 And one more time. 일다. What should we change 일다 to? Yeah, that's right. 읽었으니까. One more time. 읽었으니까. Because the verb is 이 in the verb 읽다. And 었으니까 is a ready to make 읽었으니까.
It's next problem. 운동하다. One more time. 운동하다. What should we change 운동하다 to? Yes, that's right. The answer is 운동했으니까. One more time. 운동했으니까. Okay, in the verb 했으니까 is used because.
Next problem. 있다. One more time. 있다. What should we change 있다 to? You got it? Yeah, that's right. The answer is 있었으니까. One more time. 있었으니까. Because the verb is 이 in the verb 있다. And 없으니까 is added to make 있었으니까.
Yes, next problem. 응원하다. Okay, repeat after me. 응원하다. Okay, what should we change 응원하다 to? Yeah, that's right. The answer is 응원했으니까. One more time. 응원했으니까. In this verb, 했으니까 is used because the verb 응원하다 ends with 하다.
Yeah, next problem. 씻다. And one more time. 씻다. What should we change 씻다 to? Yeah, that's right. 씻었으니까. One more time. 씻었으니까. Because the verb is 이 in the verb 씻다. And 었으니까 is added to make 씻었으니까.
Yes, next problem. 말하다. One more time. 말하다. What should we change 말하다 to? Yes, that's right. The answer is 말했으니까. Okay, one more time. 말했으니까. Okay, in this verb, 말했으니까 is used because the verb 말하다 ends with 하다. Yes, did you understand? Okay, if you understand, make a circle over your head. Yes, thank you. Everyone did a good job.
Yeah, and this is the time to finish the problem solving time. And next time, we will have conversation time with Ethan and Grace.
Okay, hello, I'm Ethan.
And I'm Grace.
Today we are going to Han River Park.
Have you ever been to Han River Park? Or do you know about Han River Park?
Yes, I know the Han River Park very well. Han River Park is one of the most famous places in Korea. And there are so many things to see and do in Hangang Park. So I often go with friends and family.
Yes, I've only been to Han River Park once. The beautiful night view I saw at the time is still unforgettable.
Then, shall we go to the Han River Park?
Wow, there are so many people.
Wow, yeah. One weekend and holiday, many people come to enjoy picnic with family and friends.
Oh, that's right. But where are those people sitting?
Oh, because you can rent a mat on the Han River Park. People People rent mats and sit there, order food for delivery and eat, or pack lunch at home and have fun talking and playing.
Seeing people eating, I'm so very hungry.
Yeah, then shall we order food for delivery? Korean has a very good delivery culture, so you can get almost any food quickly.
Yes, so what kind of food should we order?
How about pizza?
저는 어제 피자 먹었으니까 지금은 치킨 먹는 게 어때요?
아, 오케이. 저는 어제 피자 먹었으니까 지금은 치킨 먹는 게 어때요?
Here, can you see the past tense 었으니까 right in the grammar we learned today? The meaning of this sentence is I ate pizza yesterday, so how about eating chicken now? Repeat after me. 저는 어제 피자 먹었으니까 지금은 치킨 먹는 게 어때요?
Okay. 저는 어제 피자 먹었으니까 지금은 치킨 먹는 게 어때요? Here is 어제. 어제 means yesterday. And 지금 is now. Everyone, what do you say yesterday in Korean? Yes, you're right. 어제. Then what do you say in Korean? Now? Yes, now is 지금.
Let me explain how we used 었으니까. In the verb 먹다, we used 었으니까 because the verb is 어. So what does it mean to 먹다? 먹다 is eat.
I see.
Then do we go on a boat?
우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
Okay. The meaning of this sentence is we got on the boat last time. So shall we ride a bike today? Here is last time. 오늘 is today. 우리 is we. And 자전거 is bike.
Everyone, what is last time in Korean? Yes, it is 지난번. Then, what is today in Korean? Yes, it is 오늘. What is we in Korean? Yes, it is 우리. So what is bike in Korean? Yes, it is a 자전거.
Then repeat after me. Repeat after me loudly. Okay. 우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
Okay. Can you see the grammar? The grammar 왔으니까 we learned today. The verb 타다. 타다 means ride. 다 is removed from the verb 타다. And the verb 볼 is 아. So we used 왔으니까. Then we can say 탔으니까.
Everyone try to follow me again. 우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
Okay. 우리 지난번에 보트 탔으니까 오늘은 자전거 타러 갈까요?
Yes, good job.
Okay. I'm really tired because I ate chicken and rode a bicycle today in the Han River.
그럼 저희 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집에 갈까요?
그럼 저희 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집에 갈까요?
The meaning of this sentence is then since we have played enough, shall we go home now? Here, the 집 is home. 충분히 is enough. 놀다 is play. And 가다 is go.
Okay, everyone. What was home in Korean? Yes, it is 집. So what is enough in Korean? Yes, that is 충분히. Then what is play in Korean? Okay, the play is 놀다. Then what is go in Korean? Yes, it is 가다. Then repeat after me loudly, okay? 그럼 저희 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집으로 갈까요?
그럼 저희 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집에 갈까요? Can you see the grammar? 왔으니까 we learn today. When we remove 다 from the verb 놀다, the verb ends with 오. So we used 왔으니까. Then, shall we repeat after me again? 그럼 저희 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집에 갈까요?
Okay. 그럼 충분히 놀았으니까 이제 집에 갈까요? Yes, you did it so well. Grace, can I take you home by my car?
괜찮아요. 곧 버스가 온다고 했으니까 버스 타고 갈게요.
Okay, the meaning of this sentence is it's okay. The bus will be coming soon. So, I will take the bus. Here is soon. 곧 here. 곧 is soon.
Everyone, what was soon in Korean? Yes, 곧. Then, repeat after me out loud. 괜찮아요. 곧 버스가 온다고 했으니까 버스 타고 갈게요.
괜찮아요. 곧 버스가 온다고 했으니까 버스 타고 갈게요. Can you see the grammar? 왔으니까 we learned today. Because the verb is 하다. We used 했으니까. Then shall we repeat me again? 괜찮아요. 곧 버스가 온다고 했으니까 버스 타고 갈게요.
괜찮아요. 곧 버스가 온다고 했으니까 버스 타고 갈게요.
Yes, you guys followed really well.
Okay, then we will invite teacher Ariana and Kangmin and have some time to wrap it up.
Yes, did you understand all the grammar we learned today? That's great. So, let's review it now.
Today's review is 왔으니까, 었으니까, and 했으니까. First, let's review what form it is used for. Let's look at when 왔으니까 is used. 왔으니까 is used when an adjective or a vowel of a verb ends with a or o. For example, when looking at the verb 가다, 다 is first erased. Then the vowel of the verb is 아, right? In that case, 왔으니까 is used after that. So we can say 갔으니까. Next, when looking at the adjective 작다, 다 is erased first. Then the vowel of the adjective is 아, right? In that case, 왔으니까 is used after that. So we can say 작았으니까.
Ah, okay. Then I will review when 왔으니까 is used. When the pole of an adjective or verb is not 아 or 오, but the rest of the pole of 왔으니까 is used. For example, if you look at the verb 만들다, 다 is erased first. Then you can see that the voice of the verb end with the vowel 으 rather than 아 or 오. In the case 왔으니까 is used after that. So we can say 만들었으니까. Okay, next, if you see the adjective 길다, 다 is erased first. Then you can see that the vowel of the verb ends with E. In the case, 왔으니까 is used after that. So we can say 길었으니까.
Yes, lastly, I will leave it when 했으니까 is used. Verb or adjective ending in 하다 can be used by changing them to 했으니까. For example, in the verb 공부하다, the last is 하다. In that case, 했으니까 is used after that. So we can say 공부했으니까. Next, in the adjective 건강하다, it ends with 하다 as well. In that case, 했으니까 is used after that. So we can say 건강했으니까.
Then, from now on, let's review more while looking at the example sentences. This is the first example sentence. 공부를 열심히 하다. 좋은 결과가 있을 거예요. If you apply the grammar we learned today, it becomes a sentence that says 공부를 열심히 했으니까 좋은 결과가 있을 거예요. Here, 했으니까 is used because the verb ends in 하다.
This is the second example sentence. 이 영화는 시청하다. 다른 영화를 봐요. Here, 했으니까 is used because the verb ends in 시청하다. Then it becomes 이 영화는 시청했으니까 다른 영화를 봐요.
Okay, this is the third example sentence. 어제 피자를 먹다. 오늘은 스파게티 먹을래요? In this sentence, if you remove 다 from the verb 먹다, you can see that it ends with a different vowel than the vowel 아 or 오. So we can use 왔으니까. Then it becomes 어제 피자를 먹었으니까 오늘은 스파게티 먹을래요?
This is the last example. 어제 입었던 치마가 작다. 오늘은 큰 치마를 입어요. In this sentence, if you remove 다 from the verb 작다, you can see that it ends with the vowel 아. So we use 왔으니까. Then it becomes 어제 입었던 치마가 작았으니까 오늘은 큰 치마를 입어요. Do you understand? If you understand, please make a circle over your head.
Yes, thank you. Teacher Ariana, what should we do before the class is over?
Yes, it's time to do homework! Today's homework is to complete sentence using the past tense grammar we learned today.
Yes, I hope you will do hard on your homework again this time. Yes, lastly, will we have time to learn basic verb? Hello everyone! It's a fun time to learn basic words. The verbs we will learn today are 가다, 만나다, and 마시다. First, 가다 is a verb. The meaning is 고. When you go to a place or a situation, you use it. For example, when you go to a friend's birthday party, you can say 친구 생일 파티에 가다. Second, 만나다 is a verb. The meaning is meet. It is used when you meet someone or face a situation. For example, you can say 나는 지민이와 만나다. One more time, 나는 지민이와 만나다. Third, 마시다 is a verb. The meaning is drink. You use it when you drink water or drinks. For example, you can say 나는 콜라를 마신다. One more time, 나는 콜라를 마신다. Do you guys understand? I hope you use the verb we learned today in your daily life. Yes, then we will end today's class here. 여러분, 다음 시간에 봐요. Bye. 세상에 멍설이 그 부정하게 커버린 걸치거리 outsider 걸음걸이 옷차림 이어폰 넘어 playlist 음악까지 다 minor 넌 바래지 넓은 무게 위 환한 빛 조명이
Cheers.